while from now, the dignitaries will commemorate the flag hoisting event.
Symbolizes the sacrifice of the millions who died for it and peace and prosperity that prevails in our nation. It reminds of our responsibility that we have towards our nation. Now, it's time for the March Pass, which will be carried over by the Prakashites and followed by the performance of our musical band.
Permission to start band performance, sir!
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Manush will take the band, sir.
All people, dispenser of India's destiny, thy name rouses the heart of Punjab, Sindh, Gujarat and Maratha, of the Dravid and Odisha and Bengal. It echoes in the hills of Vindhya and Himalayas, mingles in the music of Ganga and Yamuna, and is chanted by the waves of Indian Sea. They pray for thy blessing and sing thy praise. The saving of all people waits in thy hands. Thou, dispenser of India's destiny, victory, victory, victory to thee.
The author and the composer of the song, Rabindranath Tagore, translated this anthem into English on 28 February 1919 at Besant Theosophical College in Madanapalli, Andhra Pradesh. The song was sung during his visit to the place. It enthralled the college students, while Margaret Cousins, then vice principal of the college, also an expert in European music and wife of Irish poet James Cousins, both requested Tagore to create an English translation of the song and set down the musical notation to the national anthem, which is followed only when the song is sung in its original slow rendition style. Tagore translated the work into English while at the college, titled The Morning Song of India.
The saga of a nation is rich and vast. 28 states, 1618 languages, 6,400 castes, 6 major religions, 6 ethnic groups, and 1 country. This shows, despite the diverse culture, tradition, languages, religion, we stand together as one. This shows our unity in diversity, and we are proud that we are Indians. Good morning, revered guests of the day, invitees, parents, director sir, and us Prakashites. Today we tend all square measure gather here to celebrate the proud day of our nation, the Republic Day of India. I, Siddharth.
I, Isha. Wish you all a very happy Republic Day. Being living in a democratic republic, we have freedom in mind, faith in words, patriotism in our souls. So let's salute to our nation on its 71st Republic Day.
But before we start with the programs, I take the opportunity to welcome in our wonderful morning the esteemed guest, Padma Bhushan Dr. Belle Monappa Hegde, co-chairman of TAGVHS Diabetes Research Center Chennai and chairman of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan Mangalore. Please join your hands as I call upon my friend Maitri to present sir with the sapling. Thank you, Maitri. I request Shruti to brief our guests to the audience.
Now I take the pleasure to introduce Dr. B.M. Hegde. Dr. B.M. Hegde, co-chairman of TAGVHS Diabetes Research Center, Chennai, and chairman of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, Mangalore, is the former vice chancellor of Manipal University. He trained in some of the best institutions in India, the UK, and the USA under great legendary teachers whose flair must have rubbed on in too. He was one of the rare Indians appointed as a regular visiting professor of cardiology at the Middlesex Indians Hospital Medical School, University of London, way back in 1982. He has been a revolutionary researcher of the refutative variety, lateral thinker, published in the UK, USA, Germany, Kuwait, China, in addition to India. His lay articles, running into thousands, both in Kannada and English, have become household names. One of India's highest civilian awards, Padma Bhushan, was awarded to him in 2010. Dr. B.C. Roy National Award in the category of Eminent Medical Teacher, the highest medical award in India, Dr. J.C. Bose Award for Research in Life Sciences, Distinct Physician of India Award, Best Teacher, Best Researcher, Best Orator Awards many times over, Karnataka Rajyotsava Award, Vaidyaratnakara Award from Shankaracharya, 12 gold medal orations and 88 other named orations are but a few awards that adorn his mantelpiece. His research organization, World Academy of Authentic Healing Sciences, with its journal, The Journal of the Science of Healing Outcomes, started with the blessings of the world-renowned scientist, late Professor Rustam Roy, has been in existence now for 10 years. This scientifically authenticates simple common healing methods for common good. Professor Hegde feels that inexpensive bedside medicine practiced by a compassionate doctor is the future of healing sciences. Late Nani Palkhiwala, a great Indian jurist, used to call him a cardiologist with a heart. Now I request sir to address the gathering.
Good morning, Prakashites. You put up a very impressive show this morning. The march past was so perfect that it looked like the army precision. Congratulations for what you have done. Friends, I am not here to make a long speech. Suffice it to say how much I enjoyed being with you all. India is now 71 years old. Many of you are born after India became independent. All of you are born after India became independent. But we have seen India before independence also. I was a small boy, a high school student, when India became independent. But all the same, India has changed a lot. And for a change now, for 70 years after independence, we didn't have Indians to rule us. We had people with foreign brains, foreign minds to rule us. But luckily, in the last 2-3 years, we have a prime minister who is very much Indian, thinks Indian, and he is very much Indian. So I hope this country has a bright future. We have come out of the shackles, true shackles of Western rule. Because I remember still, for example, the Indian sciences like yoga and other things were never popularized in the West or anywhere else because our rulers were all westernized thinkers. Now it has come to fore and we are progressing fast. And I hope these things will come into mainstream education even in schools. And I hope and pray that all of you will soon get used to having some yoga training because it gives your mind a very good outlook. Because yoga is not just a kusti or exercise. It is chitta vritti nirodha yogaha. It is something that really makes you a good human being. And all that you have to do in education is not just get the ABC of what the textbook is. I still remember the vivid memory of Sri Prakash ji being our governor. A very fine gentleman he was. And I hope his tradition continues in these institutions. And may you all have a very bright future. May each one of you become another Sri Prakash and start institutions because our youngsters should not be just looking for a job. They should be looking for opportunities to give jobs to others. So you must be all entrepreneurs and try to start something good. And these educational institutions that Sri Prakash ji has started have done well and I hope they'll go on like this. And because the government alone cannot give education to all children in India, the private efforts are important and it's a private government partnership that really sees the future of India. And I once again wish all of you a very bright future, a very good morning and a bright day and a bright year ahead. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now, I welcome our honored guest, Dr. G. Surya Prakash, Alumni AIIMS Senior Consultant Cardiologist, Care Hospital, Secunderabad. I call upon my friend Sumaya to present a sapling to Dr. G. Surya Prakash. Please join your hands. Sumaya. My friend Saranya will introduce our guest to you.
Happy Republic Day. Now, I take the privilege to introduce you to Dr. G. Surya Prakash. Dr. Gulla Surya Prakash is an alumni of AIIMS, presently Medical Director and Senior Consultant Cardiologist, Care Hospital, Secunderabad. He had a meritorious pass in his MBBS, winning gold medals in several subjects. He entered the prestigious All India Institute of Medical Sciences for MD and further specialized in DM Cardiology from the esteemed Nizam's Institute of Medical Sciences, Hyderabad. To his credit, he has more than 100 publications in various national and international journals and has attended numerous worldwide conferences and workshops, both as a delegate and as a speaker or moderator since the last 20 years. He was a recipient of the prestigious Ugadi Puraskar Award and the Vikasa Ratna Siromani Award by the Society for Friendship and National Unity, New Delhi in 2004. He received Vaidya Siromani Award from Megacity Navakala Vedika and also received Distinguished Service Awards for his outstanding and dedicated community services by Vishwamanava Samaikyata Samat Vishwamandiram Guntur. Awards and recognition of the society is only secondary to him. But what propels him ahead is the smile on the face of the sufferer once he is well. That smile and look of gratitude on the poor patient's face make Dr. G. Surya Prakash move ahead in his noble endeavor. Thank you, sir, for being with us on this wonderful occasion. Sir, please enlighten the gathering.
Good morning, Prakashites. Hearty welcome, and first of all, I wish you all the happy Republic Day, 71st Republic Day, as you all celebrating. And I don't want to take much time, as our chief guest, Dr. Hegde Saab, already he has addressed and given a few good words and encouraging the Prakashites in different ways. I think you are all definitely going in the good way with Sri Prakash Vidyaniketan's support and encouragement in the all fields, not only just education, the art, science, and the other social activities, sports. I'm very happy to be associated with this school for the last decade and knowing the developments and progress of the institutions. And here I just would like to just give few words and remind our responsibility as a citizens of India. I think everybody knows the only thing is implementation and going towards the good for the society and the nation. As a school children, all you should focus and concentrate on development of all activities, especially the education first, then the other things, social service, and what we should do and see the country grows and stays on the globe of the nation, world. So each one, I think, knows their responsibility as a citizen of India and see that, keep your footsteps in India and watch with your eyes all over the world and develop yourself as an excellent individual and citizen of India and contribute something or other to the national development and be as a human being, not just as a student or scientist or a doctor or an engineer. Be as a human being and help each other and keep growing and keep the nation on the top. I wish you all the best and success for the future, and again, happy Republic Day. Thank you very much for giving the opportunity, dear Prakashites.
Thank you, sir. I now welcome an idol of knowledge and inspiration, well-wisher of Sri Prakash Vidyaniketan, Dr. Kalasapuri Srinivas Rao, founder and MD of Indian Institution of Biotechnology Private Limited, India. Please join your hands as I call upon my friend Sharanya to present sir with the sapling. Thank you, Sharanya. I now request my three to brief sir to the audience.
Scientists are like true driving forces of civilization, says James Burke. True to the quote, Dr. Kalsapudi Srinivas Rao, founder and managing director of Indian Institute of Biotechnology, Private Limited India, is a biotechnology and biomedical scientist who aims at improving skill set and education of biotech workforce in the biotechnology industry and bringing out products needed for a large section of population in the areas of malnutrition, stress and aging. Dr. Rao has contributed a lot in the areas of molecular genetics, gene expression, regulation, matrix biology, and molecular development kit. Sir has been instrumental in the growth of new vaccine portfolio of Shanta Biotech. Sir was awarded a PhD in molecular genetics by the University of Paris with a very honorable mention for the PhD thesis. Sir has authored many books on the subject of biotechnology. Dr. Srinivas Rao has 3 patents from US to his credit in the area of inhibitors of protease activity. Sir has received scholarship awards like Research Associate Award, NIH USA Trainee Grant, Postdoctoral Fellowship, Molecular Genetics from Columbia University, New York, Doctoral Fellowship from Government of France, Paris, Research Fellowship from CCMB, Hyderabad, India, and National Merit Loan Scholarship from Ministry of Education, New Delhi, India. Dr. Rao has presented, participated, organized, co-chaired and chaired several scientific meetings in France, USA and India. Sir, it is truly an honor to have you here amidst us. Welcome to Sri Prakash, sir. I request you to enlighten the gathering.
Hello. Dear students, teachers, staff and parents, today our generation, we and your parents are the grandchildren of the people who sacrificed to celebrate this day. You are the great grandchildren of those who worked, sacrificed, and died for the freedom of this country. I'm a biologist. I strongly believe in the evolution, not only of species, but also of the societies and countries. When I was at your age, Delhi was very far. For you, it is the same distance to many countries now to travel to. The world is coming together, and one day, when you stand here, you would say that the world has become a single place. Humans have evolved. This is possible only with new ideas. Only with ideas that you hear with open mind. At this school, I really think that you are getting much more than the education through the presence of people like Dr. Hegde, Dr. Surya Prakash, and many, many dignitaries who came and tried to give you new ideas. It's a wonderful coincidence that at this stage of my life, I'm concentrating on the food and water for improving the health. Once you are healthy, a brain with a healthy body will be the right place to imbibe new ideas, and you carry this country forward to make the world a better place to live for everyone. Thank you.
We, with respect, acknowledge the humble presence of the man of distinct vision and the fountainhead of Sri Prakash Vidyaniketan, Director Sri Chitturi Vasu Prakash. Thank you, sir. This Republic Day, we are all in need for some patriotic upkeep. We bring to you the ideals and the values that India has stood for through this beautiful melody by the school choir.
Ki avasar par kavi Avinash ke dwara likhi gayi desh ke veer jawanon ke bare mein, unke tyagon ke bare mein geet gaane ja rahe hain. आइए सुनकर आप भी हमारा साथ गुनगुनाइए।
Thank you, everyone. India is the cradle of human race and birthplace of human speech. Sanskrit, the language of ancient India with the 3,500 year history remained till date. So let's welcome in Girija to render a speech in Sanskrit.
Shriman Dr. Hegde Mahodaya, Dr. Surya Prakash Mahodaya, Dr. Srinivas Rao Mahodaya, Asmakam Vidyalayaha Nirdeshakaha, Dr. Vasu Prakash Mahodaya. Sarvebhya Namo Namaha, Atro Pasya Sarvebhya Ganatantra Divasasya Shubhabhi Nandanani, Asmakam Desha Navdashatamadikam Saptachatvarimshat, Tamsi Varshasya Agas Masasya Panchadasha Dinanke Swatantram Abhavat, Parantu Tadanim Asya Kimpi Swakiya Samvidhanam Naasit. अतः डॉक्टर अंबेडकरः वल्लभभाई पटेलः गोपाल स्वामीः इत्यादि महोदयानाम् अध्यक्षतया संविधान निर्माणम् अभवत् यदा संविधान निर्माणम् कार्यं समाप्तम् अभवत् तदा तम् अंगीकृत्य देशे 950-55 वर्षे जनवरी मासस्य 26 दिनाङ्के भारतदेशः पूर्णरूपेण स्वतन्त्रः अभवत् सम्पूर्णं प्रभुत्वसम्पन्नं समाजवादिनम् आर्थिकं राजनीतिकं च न्यायं विचारस्य अभिव्यक्तं धर्मस्य उपासनया च स्वतन्त्रताम् इत्यादि विषयाणि संविधाने प्रस्तुतवन्तः अस्माकं देशस्य पुरोगतिः एव अस्माकं कर्तव्यम् अतः वयं सर्वे मिलित्वा देशस्य उन्नतिं करिष्यामः जयतु भारतं जयतु संस्कृतं धन्यवाद
इल्गिरिजा It is said that speech is the mirror of the soul. As he speaks, so is he. So I would like to invite Karthi Shri to express her views on the Republic Day in our native language, Telugu.
దేశమును ప్రేమించుమన్న మంచి అన్నది పెంచుమన్న వట్టి మాటలు కట్టి పెట్టోయ్ గట్టి మేలు తలపెట్టువోయ్ అన్నారు గురుజాడ నమస్కారం నా పేరు కార్తీ శ్రీ ఈనాటి 71వ గణతంత్ర దినోత్సవ వేడుకలకు విచ్చేసిన బిఎం హెగ్డే గారికి సూర్యప్రకాష్ గారికి శ్రీనివాసరావు గారికి డైరెక్టర్ గారికి తల్లిదండ్రులకు ఉపాధ్యాయులకు నా తోటి విద్యార్థులకు పేరు పేరున గణతంత్ర దినోత్సవ శుభాకాంక్షలు తెలియజేసుకుంటున్నాను 1947 ఆగస్ట్ 15 మన దేశానికి స్వాతంత్రం వచ్చింది 1950 జనవరి 26 మన రాజ్యాంగాన్ని రాజ్యాంగ సభ ఆమోదించింది అసలు రాజ్యాంగం ఎందుకు 1947 స్వాతంత్రం సంపాదించుకున్న మనకు సరైన రాజ్యాంగం లేదు అప్పటి వరకు బ్రిటిష్ వారి 1935 భారత ప్రభుత్వ చట్టం మాత్రమే అమల్లో ఉండేది అందువల్ల పరిపాలనకు సరైన విధి విధానాలను కలిగే ఒక రాజ్యాంగం అవసరమనే ఉద్దేశంతో దేశ దేశాలు తిరిగి అంబేద్కర్ మరియు మరికొంతమంది నాయకులు కలిసి 1946 రాజ్యాంగ రచన ప్రారంభించి 2 సంవత్సరాల 11 నెలల 18 రోజుల కృషి చేసి ప్రపంచంలోకెల్లా అతిపెద్ద మరియు లిఖిత రాజ్యాంగాన్ని రచించి మనకు అందించారు ఆనాడే గణతంత్ర దినోత్సవాన్ని ప్రకటించారు కానీ 1930 జనవరి 26 జరిగిన జాతీయ కాంగ్రెస్ సమావేశంలో నెహ్రూ మొదలైన నాయకులు పూర్ణ స్వరాజ్యను తీర్మానించారు అదే రోజున గణతంత్ర దినోత్సవాన్ని జరుపుకోవాలని నిశ్చయించుకుని ప్రతి ఏటా జనవరి 26 గణతంత్ర దినోత్సవ వేడుకలను యావత్ భారతదేశం ఆనందంగా జరుపుకుంటుంది పెద్దలు చక్కని బాటలు వేస్తే దాన్ని రాచబాటగా తీర్చిదిద్దుకోవాల్సిన బాధ్యత మన చేతుల్లోనే ఉంది నేటి బాలలే రేపటి పౌరులు కనుక నాటి నాయకుల ఆశయాలు ఆలోచనలు సరైన మార్గంలో పెట్టి దేశాన్ని ఉన్నత స్థాయికి చేర్చగలిగేది నేటి పౌరులే నేడు మన కళ్ళ ముందు అనేక సమస్యలు కనబడుతున్నాయి ఉదాహరణకు కులమత భేదాలు అవినీతి నిరుద్యోగ సమస్య మహిళలపై అకృత్యాలు పర్యావరణ కాలుష్యం నిరక్షరాస్యత ఇలా చెప్పుకుంటూ పోతే ఎన్నో మరెన్నో మన కళ్ళ ముందు మెదలాడుతున్నవే ఇలాంటి సమస్యలపై స్పందించి వాటిని పరిష్కరించుకున్న నాడే మన దేశం అభివృద్ధి పడడంలో నడవగలదు ఒక్క చినుకు చాలు మట్టి కుక్కను పలికించాలంటే ఫలితం అందేది తీవ్ర పరిణామంలోనే సుమా అని సి నారాయణ రెడ్డి గారు అన్నట్లు ఒక్క ప్రయత్నం చాలు మన సమస్యలు పరిష్కరించడానికి ఇలా ప్రతి ఒక్కరూ ఏనాడైతే ఆలోచిస్తారో అప్పుడు మన దేశం ఉన్నత స్థానాన్ని అధిరోహిస్తుంది వివేకానందుడు చెప్పినట్టు మానవ సేవే మాధవ సేవ దీనులకు సహాయం చేయండి రైతుల ఆర్తనాదాల్లో పాలు పంచుకోండి పర్యావరణాన్ని పరిరక్షించండి స్త్రీలను గౌరవించండి ఇవన్నీ మన చేతుల్లో ఉన్నవన్నీ గమనించండి. దేశ అభివృద్ధికి మీ చేయూతనివ్వండి. నాకు ఈ అవకాశం ఇచ్చిన మీ అందరికీ మరి ఒకసారి గణతంత్ర దినోత్సవ శుభాకాంక్షలు తెలియజేసుకుంటూ సెలవు తీసుకుంటున్నాను. జై హింద్.
నమస్తే. వి ప్రజెంట్ బిఫోర్ యువర్ సాంగ్ అబౌట్ ద గ్రేట్నెస్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా, పబ్లిష్ బై భారత్ వికాస్ పరిషత్ ఇన్ చేతనా కేశ్వర్, పేజ్ నెంబర్ 23, కంపోజ్డ్ ఇన్ రాగమాలిక.
Thank you, girls. It was fun. Ye Hindustan hamara. Now let's invite Utkarsh to render a speech in Hindi.
सागर जिसके पांव पखारे, हिमालय जिसका सरताज है, गूंज रहा दुनिया में डंका, भारत का खुशियों का दिन आज है। आदरणीय बी एम हेगडे जी, श्रीनिवास राव जी, जी प्रकाश जी, सूर्य प्रकाश जी, डायरेक्टर सर, अध्यापक व अध्यापिकाएं और मेरे प्यारे सहपाठियों, सुप्रभात। मैं उत्कर्ष शुक्ला, नवी कक्षा का विद्यार्थी, आपके सामने उपस्थित हूँ। जैसा कि आपको विदित है कि आज हम सब यहाँ गणतंत्र दिवस के उपलक्ष्य में एकत्रित हुए हैं। देशभक्तों के त्याग, तपस्या और बलिदान की अमर कहानी 26 जनवरी का पर्व समेटे हुए है। गणतंत्र का अर्थ है गढ़ तो प्लस तंत्र, यानी कि जनता के द्वारा जनता के लिए शासन। हमारे देश का संविधान 26 जनवरी सन 1950 में लागू हुआ था। भारत के महान स्वतंत्रता सेनानियों ने कड़ी मेहनत और संघर्ष करके ही भारत को पूर्व स्वराज दिलाया। महात्मा गांधी, भगत सिंह, चंद्रशेखर आज़ाद, लाला लाजपत राय आदि अनेक देशभक्तों ने देश को आज़ाद कराने के लिए अपनी जान निछावर कर दी। संविधान बनाने के लिए हम इन नेताओं का योगदान कैसे भूल सकते हैं। बी आर अम्बेडकर जी भारतीय संविधान के पिता कहलाए जाते हैं। वह हमारे संविधान के मुख्य वास्तुकार थे। अम्बेडकर जी को सन 1990 में भारत रत्न से सम्मानित किया गया था। आंध्र प्रदेश की माटी में जन्मी भारत की वीर बेटी, उत्तर प्रदेश की पहली महिला राज्यपाल सरोजिनी नायडू ने भी भारत के संविधान निर्माणित करने में अपना योगदान दिया। टीटी कृष्णमाचार्य जी, जयपाल सिंह जी, डॉक्टर राजेंद्र प्रसाद जी के योगदान को भी हम कैसे भूल सकते हैं। किंतु आज कितने दुख की बात है कि आज़ादी के इतने वर्षों के बाद भी हम अपराध, भ्रष्टाचार और हिंसा जैसी गंभीर समस्याओं से जूझ रहे हैं। अब समय आ गया है कि आज के हम युवा एक दूसरे का हाथ थाम कर देश में फैली बुराइयों का दहन कर दें और विविधता में एकता और अखंडता को बनाए रखें, जिसके लिए हम सबको एकजुट होकर अपने देश को उच्च शिखर तक पहुंचाना है। तो आइए हम सब जाति, धर्म और समुदाय से ऊपर उठकर भारतीयता की पहचान दें और हमारे देश को सफलता की नई उड़ान दें। अंत में इन शब्दों के द्वारा अपनी वाणी को विराम देता हूँ। जो भरा नहीं है भावों से, जिसमें बहती रसधार नहीं, वह हृदय नहीं पत्थर है, जिसमें स्वदेश का प्यार नहीं। जय हिंद, जय भारत।
यूनियन टेरिटरीज लद्दाख एंड जम्मू एंड कश्मीर। इंडिया बैन्स ट्रिपल तलाक। अरुणिमा सिन्हा बिकम्स वर्ल्ड्स फर्स्ट वुमन एम्प्यूटी टू स्केल माउंट विंशन। ड्यूटी चंद बिकम्स द फर्स्ट इंडिया स्प्रिंटर टू विन गोल्ड एट यूनिवर्सिटी। पीवी सिंधु बिकम्स फर्स्ट इंडियन टू विन वर्ल्ड चैंपियनशिप्स। इंडिया विन्स द साउथ एशियन गेम्स 2019 विद द हाईएस्ट एवर टैली ऑफ 312 मेडल्स। हिमा दास विन्स 5 गोल्ड्स इन अ मंथ इन पॉन्सन एथलेटिक्स ग्रैंड प्री इन पोलैंड। Guneet Monga's film End of Sentence wins an Oscar. Nawazuddin Siddiqui's Sacred Games wins Emmy. Videesha Balyan becomes first Indian to be crowned Miss Deaf World 2019. And the list goes on. This is just a short list of achievement of the country in 2019. Name any field, we are there. With pride in my heart, I declare Mera Bharat Mahan. Honorable guests on the dais, Dr. Padma Bhushan Bele Monappa Hegde, Dr. Surya Prakash, Dr. Kalasapudi Srinivas Rao, Well-Wisher of Sri Prakash Mr. Roy, Director Sir, Principal and us Prakashites. Today we have assembled here to celebrate our Republic Day and also our transition from a colonial governed state to independent republic. This day, 71 years ago, India adopted its constitution, one of the finest in the whole world. The document which is the heart and soul of the nation, making us proud Republicans from that day on. And the progress is in leaps and bounds. To be truthful, the freedom and the right that we enjoy today as citizens of India, not forgetting to mention the democratic setup, we owe it all to our constitution and to the people who created it. Friends, this is the Republic of India. Here we are, its two stakeholders. We are all the pillars of the nation in our own capacities. Each and every single Prakashite is a pillar on whom the legacy of Republic of India must stand on. Bharat Mata Ki! Jai! Bharat Mata Ki! Jai! Bharat Mata Ki! Jai! Thank you. Over to Maitri.
And it's an education. It's not just simply entertainment or fight. Those who practice traditional taekwondo follow 5 tenets: courtesy, integrity, perseverance, self-control, and indomitable spirit. they physically are able to defend themselves and their loved ones. But really, what it's doing is building up their character, and that's what they get in the 21st century as a modern day warrior. So watch the modern world warriors performing Taekwondo.
One nation, one vision, one identity. From labor to leaders, everyone's participation is essential in nation building. Mera pehchan, mera Bharat. Happy Republic Day to all of you.
It's time now to announce the winners of the Bharat Vikas Parishad competition and the book quiz. Now I request our esteemed guests to give away the prizes. Shri Prakash Vidyaniketan believes in inculcating reading habits among students. The school conducted an intra-school book quiz on the book Neil Armstrong. The first prize winner is VVS Shita of class 7, Ravya of class 9. And the third prize winner is Akanksha of class 9.
Prakash, it's excellent Bharat Vikas Parishad NGSE competition. Students from Sri Prakash Vidyaniketan Vishakhapatnam made their school, city and state proud by bagging the third prize in the 45th national level All India Group Singing Competition 2019 held at Rajkot, Gujarat. The team reached national level by standing first in among 5 lakh participants at the district, state and regional levels. They received the prize from the Union Minister of the State for Shipping, Mr. Mansukh L. Mandavia. Please join your hands as I call upon the winners. Bhuvana Kruti of 6th, GNL Janavi of 9th, H. Amrita Varshini of 9th, K. Ananya Lasi of 6th, Mercy Mukta of 9th, Praharshita of 9th and Varis of 7th. Please give them a huge round of applause.
Prize goes to G. Rishwick. From class 2nd, first prize goes to B. Ruthwick. Second prize, M. Ritesh. Third prize, M. Manashwini. From class 3, first prize, N. Tejasri. Second prize, third, V. Srikar Ashish. Please give them a huge round of applause.
From the event social quiz, 4th class, first prize goes to Denisha Roy. Second prize, C.H. Arsini. 5th class, first prize, D. Lassia Priya. Second prize, Y.S.S. Ritwik. Class 6th, first prize, B. Sita Rama Krishna Kesari. Second prize, Saurav Maheshwari. Class 7th, first prize, Ayush Vaishraj. Second prize, Chitrata Hasit. Class 8th, first prize, Siddharth Patel. Second prize, S. Bhavya Shri. Class 9, first prize, G. Hemant. Applause. Second prize.
T. S. Swadha. Second, V. Anusha Kalidhini. Class 6, first, Z. Haider Salih Shamar. Second, B. Sita Rama Krishna Kesari.
Second prize, J. Yashwant Sai. Class 7, first prize, S. Kaushal. Second prize, K. Harshit. Class 8, first prize, Suhan Sanamanda. Second prize, N.Y. Gupta. Class 9, S. Tanuj. First prize. Second prize, L. Navadeep.
S. Krishna Kesari. Class 7, Venkat Sai. Class 8, S. Abhirup. Class 9, K. Krishna Sastri. Please give them a huge round of applause.
Pika. Class 7, first prize, M. Abhiram. Second prize, B. Sai Pranay. Class 8, first prize, Pujita. Second prize, Hari Krishna.
Dr. B.M. Hegde, to honor our venerated guest, Dr. G. Surya Prakash, an expression of our gratitude. But I believe that the feeling of patriotism and fraternity will always stay with us. I would like to specially thank our honorable guest for today, Padma Bhushan Dr. Belle Munapa Hegde, the co-chairman of TAG VHS Diabetes Research Center, Chennai, and the chairman of Bharat Vidya Bhavan in Mangalore, for his valuable time with us and also for his wonderful speech, which has enlightened us and inspired us in many ways. I would also like to thank Dr. G. Surya Prakash, senior consultant cardiologist, Care Hospital, Secunderabad. Without him, this auspicious function would not have been a success. I thank Dr. Kalasapudi Srinivasa Rao, MD of the Indian Institute of Biotechnology, Private Limited. Special thanks to Mr. Rai for his presence on this auspicious day. Thank you very much, sir. I thank Director Sir, Admin Officers, and the Principal, not to forget all the teachers, the volunteers, the students, the participants, and those who have sacrificed everything to make this function happen, for their efforts and hard work in organizing, decorating, participating, and in many other ways. I would like to thank all of you for your help and your effort to make this function a success. Thank you all. Thank you, India. Jai Hind.
ASC competition held at Rajkot in Gujarat. The winners receive awards from Union Minister of State for Shipping, Mr. Mansukh L. Mandavia. Let us enjoy the melodious Sanskrit song.
Namaste. We present before you a song about the greatness of India, published by Bharat Vikas Parishad in Rashtriya Geetika, page number 25, composed in Ragamalika.
Bhavadani sa, Bhavadani sa, Bhavadani sa, garam sa, gare. संस्कृतम् संस्मरामो वयम् भारतम् भारतीयम् नमामो वयम् भारतम् भारतीयम् नमामो वयम् सारनि सगसनिदा मदनि रनि सगमगसा
breathing life into fantasies that seem faint.
Just a twist of the wrist is not what artists do. Beautiful windows opening to mind's mist of thoughts churning brew.
A world of colors much beyond the darkness you can find. Paradises further than those seen, the kingdom of mind.
A piece of art is so much more, the stories to be told in black and white. A painting is new world's core, the magic's beholder's sight. This poem is written by our senior friend, Licia Saikia from class 10.
Art is as natural as sunshine and as vital as nourishment. Art has the role in education of helping children become like themselves instead of someone else, and so every child is an artist.
Hello Shravya, what is it all about art? By the way, you look very happy.
Yes, when patriotic fervor radiated by the inspiring speeches of our distinguished guests fill your heart, it's hard not to be jubilant. Anyway, do you see some of our children working on a big canvas behind?
Yes, I do. But what are their plannings in such a big way?
Now that's a big surprise. Let me keep you as well as the audience guessing.
Let's invoke the blessings of Goddess Saraswati, the mother of all knowledge and art in every form. Here come our friends Janvi and Amrita with a melodious song on Ma Saraswati. Let's welcome them.
Saraswati te Shive chita nande Shiva sahite Shri Saraswati te Shive chita nande Shiva sahite Shri Saraswati te Kama koti nilaye काम कोटि निलये तरह दमने वलये काम कोटि निलये तरह दमने वलये कोमल तरार नये गुरु गुहोदये माम वसने कोमल Shri Saraswati te Shive Chitanande Shiva Sahite Shri Saraswati te Kaam Koti Nilaye Taya Hrida Mani Valaye Kaam Koti Nilaye Taya Saraswati te Shive Chitanande Shiva Sahite Shri Saraswati te Shive Chitanande Shiva Sahite Shri Saraswati te
Amrita, that was very befitting and mellifluous.
I feel it's also the right time to recall some of the best moments of achievement of Prakash Heights this year, especially in the field of art. More so as our school literally serves as an incubator for art and craft and many other visual arts. This year has been a remarkable year for us, what with all those never before feats of achievements of our friends. I really feel fortunate and proud to be a Prakash Heights for having been blessed with innumerable opportunities to nurture our talents in various fields.
I agree with you there totally, but can you elaborate a little on those glorious moments?
Of course, my pleasure. To start with, our friends have bagged the first and second places in the various inter-school painting competitions held on different occasions like World Environment Day, Balabharatam by Inadu, Save Tiger Painting Competition organized by the Zoo Authority, Hare Krishna Movement by Heritage Fest, Rotary Club Spawn Painting Competition, Vikram Sarabhai Centenary Program Drawing Competition, Energy Conservation Painting Competition and Petrol Conservation Painting Competition.
Wow, the list looks very impressive. I think some of these achievements have been made at the state level also.
Of course, coming back to our friends, could you guess anything so far?
Not really. I'm sure something is amazing underway. They're working really fast.
Yes, the big picture has always been an exciting moment of all our celebrations where the little hands of our blossoming artists paint magic and spellbind the audience. They use simple acrylic colors on canvas with precision. All that right in front of the audience and that too in a few minutes. Isn't that an amazing act of teamwork and artistry? Thanks to the expert guidance of our art teachers.
No wonder then that out of 20 finalists of the national level Doodle for Google contest this year, 9 are Prakash Heights and 3 of them have won the prizes in the group category. They beat almost 1 lakh contestants from across the country. I think that was a record in itself.
Great! Can you name the children who achieved it?
Yes. Sai Satwik, GSS Sharwan and P. Vijay Kumar. They have really brought laurels to the school.
Well said, Rupanjali. Not only that, how can we forget the unique way we celebrated the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi this year?
You mean the exhibition organized by our school with the 150 charcoal drawings of Gandhiji drawn by our artist friends?
Yes, it captivated the minds of the art lovers of not only Vizag but also our capital city, Delhi.
It is indeed a unique way of paying tribute to our Mahatma by showcasing some of the important moments of his life captured beautifully on paper only with charcoal and pencil, keeping with his simplicity.
Do you know, Rupanjali, the exhibition was received with immense accolades and encouragement from a galaxy of eminent personalities like Ms. Suhasini Haider, Padma Bhushan Ms. Romila Thapar, Mr. Jairam Ramesh, Ms. Chalu Jindal, Mr. Vinod Darus, Professor Hukum Singh, to name a few. The best moment was when the granddaughter of Mahatma Gandhi, Ms. Tara Gandhi Bhattacharya, was all the prizes for the Prakashites for bringing alive Gandhi through their drawings. Rupanjali, every moment is a celebration and invocation is a way of life for our Prakashites. We paid an artistic tribute to Swami Vivekananda on the World Youth Day on his birth anniversary, and you know how?
Of course, yes, in a very novel and exclusive way through some 17 beautiful portraits of Swamiji drawn on paper leaves with simple acrylic colors.
By the way, immersed in our conversation, we have forgotten to check up with our friends. Let's see their progress.
I think they are working with lot of concentration.
Let's observe them keenly and try to guess what the picture is. Have you got any idea about the picture?
No, not yet.
Okay, let's ask the audience. Do you have any idea what this picture is? But you have to wait for it.
I think they're going to reveal it in a short while.
Hold your breath, friends. The time has already come. And they are going to reveal it in few minutes. I think they are working really hard.
Yes. I can't wait to see the big revelation. Do you all also want to know what it is? Hold your breath, friends.
The wait is finally over. And here you go. So audience, who is it? Yes, it's none other than our distinguished guest, Shri B.M. Hegde. Please give a huge round of applause. Now let me take the opportunity to introduce these children, child prodigies to you. Here come Raja Rohit. Muazullah,
now I hope all of you have enjoyed the big picture as much as we did.
Cherishing this moment.
Through the illusion they used to hide, the monsters who eat them inside, and the world that they keep disguised. How true! We have disguised the world with plastic monsters. They are eating us and we hardly realize it. Come, let us watch together what message our friends have brought for us to heal this earth.
What's going on?
We did it! Let's get this party started. I've been seeing too many nowadays. Our sea is littered with these. Plastic bags are harmful to wildlife and marine life. Birds, animals, and marine life often mistake the plastic bag and other plastic materials for food and consume them. Plastic in the digestive system gets congested, leading to their slow, painful death. Plastic takes up to 1,000 years to decompose. So even after killing an animal, it goes on to kill many more. If we don't act, it'll be too late for everyone. India generates about 26,000 tons of plastic waste every day, and only 10% of it gets recycled.
That means we have a lot to do.
Let's get started.
छोड़ो प्लास्टिक थैली हम सब ने अब ठानी अपना लो कपड़े की कोई थैली नई पुरानी ये सोच सयानी छोड़ो प्लास्टिक थैली हम सब ने अब ठानी अपना लो कपड़े की कोई थैली नई पुरानी ये सोच सयानी
Can I get you something to drink? Yes, we will have some lemonade. But no straws, please.
ये सोच सयानी
I would like to buy this pack of bottles, please. Sure, madam. But mom, I could refill my reusable bottle. Oh, it's okay. This is cheap and easy and we can use and throw. Mom, I love you. But I have another mother. My mother nature. I love her too. I don't think she would like it if we keep using her resources. Be the change that you want to see.
शुक्रिया अदा
प्लास्टिक ने साथ जो दिया मिस यूज ना करेंगे से ये वादा कर लिया
समंदर से
Love our Mother Nature, the protector of everyone.
We make plastic, we buy plastic, we use plastic, and we have to stop this.
If you want to use it, then reuse it.
It's not yours, not mine, it's ours.
So, protect your mother who nourishes you. We are taking an oath not to pollute the earth.
Are you with us?
Tick, 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 tick. कसम ये खाए रे टिक 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 प्लास्टिक टिक ना पाए रे टिक 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 कसम ये खाए रे टिक 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 प्लास्टिक टिक ना पाए रे
अगर सुन लो जो संभले ना हम तो बम ये फट जाएगा कि बहती इसी नदिया का ये पानी रुक जाएगा
कि गर्द धरती का ये दम भी घुट जाएगा कि कुदरत की हनस नस में जहर ये बस जाएगा
प्लास्टिक के हम सब मोहताज हैं कैसा ये समाज है
कल ना हो हाथों में आज है
मौका ये अपना गवाए
टिक ना पाए रे
सिचुएशन ड्रास्टिक है जहां देखो वही प्लास्टिक है सिचुएशन ड्रास्टिक है जहां देखो वही
थैली बोतल स्ट्रॉ इत्यादि सर्रे सर्रे में फैला दे ना घट पाए ना मिट पाए रह रह के टॉक्सिक बन जाए इससे छुटकारा तो नहीं पर है एक सरल उपाय रे सिंगल यूज प्लास्टिक को हम कह दे बाय बाय रे
Friends, patriotism is the passionate love one has for his own country. This virtue pushes him to work for the country selflessly and make it better. A truly developed country is made up of true patriots. The love for motherland can only be felt within and shown in different ways. Dear audience, hold your breath and watch us Prakasha is performing, instilling patriotic fervor in all present here.
Oh,
ಇಂಡಿಯಾ
ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ದೇಶ
ಅನೋಖ ದೇಶ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ
ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ದೇಶ ಅನೋಖ
बेटों की तरह सब रहते हैं
है मैसेज हमारा प्यार प्यार
ओ अनोखा देश इंडिया
इंडिया देश अनोखा
अनोखा देश इंडिया
इंडिया देश अनोखा